morning students. Today we are going to see chapter 4 of Maths 1, Ratio and Proportion. Now in the earlier classes you already studied about this ratio and proportion. No need to explain or no need to introduce this topic. Already you know about that. But simply I want to say that ratio, what is ratio? You know very well. The molecular formula of water, H2O. You know very well, molecular formula of water. It means here in this water, hydrogen and oxygen both are present in 1:8. 1:8 in this ratio. So like that we can say that sometimes in our daily life we can use many times ratio, this ratio concept. You can see in इडली, इडली का मान आप जानते हैं. इडली के समय में हम इडली में क्या करते हैं, अगर हमें थ्री बाउल्स, अगर हमने चावल लिया है, राइस लिया है, वन बाउल हम उड़द दाल लेते हैं, मतलब उसका रेशो कितना हो गया, राइस और पल्सेस का रेशो कितना हुआ, राइस का पल्सेस वाज 3:1. सो इन दिस वे दिस इज कॉल्ड द रेशो. सो हियर नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सी दैट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द रेशो. Before that, direct proportion and inverse proportion we are seeing. Direct proportion. Direct proportion, it means if one quantity is increasing, so another quantity also increasing with that. For example, here some examples are given. Petrol x liter and distance y kilometer. If 1 liter petrol is there, we can complete 10 kilometer distance in 1 liter petrol, 20, 200, 40, 400 like that. So the ratio is 1:10. If one is increasing, another one also increasing. Here petrol is increasing, distance also increasing. This is called the direct proportion. In the same manner, in inverse proportion you can see here, vehicle and speed and distance. If we increase the speed of the vehicle, we can complete the distance of present distance in particular or in less time. It means when we increase the speed, the time is going to decrease. So that's why we can say that this is called the inverse proportion. If one quantity is increasing, another quantity also increasing, that is called direct proportion. If one quantity is decreasing, another quantity is increasing, it is called inverse proportion. Now here in properties of ratio, you can see page number 59. Some properties are given. Ratio of numbers A and B, we write A and B in this way. A is to be A double dot B or A upon B. A is the producer. A is the producer and B is the successor. B is the successor. So here in this way, we can see that second term is the successor and first term is the producer. In the ratio two numbers, if the second term is 100, then it is known as percentage. If the in any ratio, if we write that 90/100, it means this is called 90%. So if in any ratio successor is given is 100, we consider as the percentage. And third one, the ratio remains unchanged if its terms are multiplied or divided by non-zero number. अगर हम किसी भी रेशो में, कोई भी रेशो में अगर हम multiply and divide करते जाते हैं नंबर को, तो वो टर्म अनचेंज रहते हैं. It means, for example, we see here we take 2/3 ratio. We multiply 2 on both side. What we get? 4/6. It means 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are 6. Ratio is same, 2/3. In the same manner, when we multiply by 3, so we will get 3 into 3. It means 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. Ratio is same. 3 2s are 6, 3 3s are 9. The basic ratio is same, 2:3. When we multiply any number, non-zero number, or divide by any non-zero number, the ratio cannot be changed. Then next, the quantity taken in the ratio must be expressed in the same unit. This is the important point. We have to explain that if we take one quantity in kg, so another quantity also we have to take in kg, not in gram. Always we have to take it. Somebody we are taking that here whatever you want to convert, you can convert it, no problem. But remember one thing, you have to put both the unit, both the term in the same unit, in years or in months. So, and the fifth one is the ratio of two quantities is unitless. All it is very easy. Let's see, we can take same quantity, same unit, so we can cancel both the units. So that is the 2 upon 3. So here the ratio is always unitless. We cannot say the ratio has any unit. So now we start that practice set 4.1. In practice set 4.1, question number 1, from the following pairs of numbers, find the reduced form of ratio of first number to second number. Practice set 4.1. First question. First one is very simple, 72 and 60. So we have to see that in this ratio, the common multiple. So common multiple, we will find out that we can 72 and 60. Both are coming in 12 table. 12 into 6 and 12 into 5. So 12 cancel. This is the way, 6 upon 5. So in this way you can find out, you can convert in the ratio term. So find the reduced form of ratio for first number to second number. So remaining 2 1 is homework for you. Remember the student. And in the second question, find the reduced form of the ratio of the first quantity to the second quantity. In the first one, it is given in both the term in rupees. So you can convert in reduced form. Second term, first term is given in rupees, but second term is given in rupees and both in paise. So we have to convert in paise or we have to convert in rupees. So first question is homework for you today. Today is tomorrow we will see the second question of this practice set 4.1. Thank you.